Good afternoon, everyone. My name's Robert. I drove all the way down here from New Jersey. And, you know, I come out here, and I put a lot of gas money in the gas tank to come down here, but I love each one of you. That's my only motive, is that I love each one of you. And it breaks my heart, man. What's going on here is individuals determine morality. We are making our own standards. You know, I talk to a lot of people who love the same sex, and they say, what's the matter with that? You know, I love them. What's the matter with love? Actually, it's luck. It's not love, it's luck. When you don't do it God's way. And there's a standard. Individuals do not determine morality. Society does not determine morality. We have a transcendent standard. God's standard. God says it's wrong. The sad thing is, one day you'll wake up and before a holy righteous God, and you'll stand before a holy righteous God, and he's going to show you. The word of God says, do not be deceived. The unrighteous, no fornicator, no adulterer, no homosexual enter the gates of heaven. 1 Corinthians 6:9. There is a standard, and there's a transcendent standard, and it's God's standard.
I love the rainbow,
honey. The Bible
says
to not be deceived.
What? The rainbow.
Ain't gonna love hell, sir.
I love the rainbow. God is appointed to die, and after that is a judgment.
Don't be deceived by those people, man.
You're wicked, man. God.
Walk away from those people, man.
The Bible clearly says when a man lays down with a man, it's abomination before a holy righteous God. The body is outside of the nature of God. The body was not made for anal sex. It destroys the body. And God has warned you about that lifestyle. God has warned you about that lifestyle. 100 years from now, this will be nothing. Your soul will spend eternity somewhere. My prayer is you repent and call on Jesus Christ today. Repent from that lifestyle. Because the most precious thing on the face of the earth is your soul. Why would you sell your soul for homosexuality? Why would you sell your soul for that? And a lot of people say, well, I was born that way. That's like a prisoner going before a judge and saying, I was born to be a pyromaniac, judge. I was born to be a kleptomaniac, judge. I was born to be a serial killer, judge. Not going to work before a civil court, judge. Not going to work before the God of the universe. Not gonna work. So I come out here in love.
Every year.
Every year. Bring your kids off. Call on Jesus Christ. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. All things pass. All things become new. In your mind, if you really think you were born that way, that's why you need to be born again. That's why you need to be born again. The Bible clearly says, if you're not born again, you'll not enter the gates of heaven. If I come out here in love, cry out. It's like if there was a fire in the house, I would yell, get out of the house. So I'm warning you to repent from this lifestyle. Individuals do not determine what's right or wrong. Society does not determine what's right or wrong. God does. The creator
of the universe. Man. Man, dressed like a woman.
Is a gift from God. And you shake your fist at him. I'm going to do it my way. I'm going to do it my way, God. I'm going to make a God to suit myself. My God would never throw anybody to hell. My God would have no problem about same sex, homosexuality. You're 100% right. Your God would never have a problem about homosexuality or throw anybody to hell. Because of the God you made up in your own mind. It's a figmentation of your own mind. That God does not exist. And you'll meet the God of the universe. But you have a conscience. You have a conscience. The Bible says the law is written in our hearts. You know, I go like to the Bronx. Go to Newark, Jersey.
I'm okay.
I don't know.
I've been
to see you.
Yeah.
You're so high.
How do you know it's wrong?
Ladies dressed like men. Horrible.
When lay down, my man.
I pray
lay
to repent. Tell me, Jesus.
You know your conscience is telling you it's wrong. But you can fear your conscience. You can fear your conscience. Say to yourself, you know what? I'm going to do it my way. And God will do it His way. When you stand before, on that day, you'll stand before a holy, righteous God. So it's my prayer that you repent and call on Jesus Christ today. Call on Him. To break any bondage.
Nice meeting, Kathy.
The Bible says He came to set the captive free. He came to set him free. You don't have to be in bondage to homosexuality. It's a lie from the devil, and he wants you in hell. He hates you. He wants you in hell. And he's deceiving you. You get on your knees and call to Jesus. Repent from that lifestyle. You spend eternity in heaven. You can mock him. Say, I'm going to do it my way. The Bible says God is just God. So your soul is so precious. Why would you sell your soul for homosexuality? 100 years from now, this will be nothing. All this will be nothing. So I'm going to be off in eternity. You'll be spending eternity somewhere. Sold your soul for homosexuality, you'll spend eternity in hell. Jesus spoke about hell when he spoke about heaven. It's a horrible place. You're weeping, you gnash your teeth. Eternal torment. Fire's never quenched. Because either you repent and call on Jesus, and he pays for your sin on the cross, or you'll spend eternity in hell paying for your sin. You have a conscience. You know what's right or wrong. Repent. Call what the Bible says.
Thank you, man.
But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female.
Go buy yourself a dress.
For this reason, a man shall leave his father.
Oh, boy.
And mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. So then, they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate. Let no man separate. Adam and Eve. Not Adam and Steve. Adam and Eve.
Amen.
So you fake, shake your fist at God and say, I'm going to do it my way.
Adam either.
Body was not made for that kind of lifestyle.
Praise the Lord.
Why?
How you doing, man?
It was not made that way.
Yeah.
Between a male and a male, it was not made that way.
It's horrible.
Ain't no sex.
Oh, his wife called my word. It's a lot of stuff, man. We'll talk later, man.
If I come out here and warn you in love.
Come here. Come here, I'll give you something.
Repent from that lifestyle. I don't want to see you
my
in
wife's,
hell.
Oh, let me
it's my
share.
Only motive. We're not out here with a church. Mm-hmm. We're not here asking money. Come out here in love. Hell is a real thing. It's not worth your soul for homosexuality. 150,000 people die every day. Every 13 minutes, somebody will die in a car crash. And you'll stand before a holy, righteous God.
She couldn't wait.
And you'll spend eternity in hell because you did it your way. My prayer is you repent and trust Jesus Christ. That's my prayer. You know, many people say, well, I was born that way. You know, I was born to be a pyromaniac. I was born to be a
pyromaniac.
I was born to be a serial killer. You know, I was born to be a murderer.
Trust Jesus.
I can't help it. I was born to be a murderer. It's not going to work before a civil court judge. It's not going to work before the God of the universe. You need to stop playing games with your soul and repent. Call on Jesus Christ. You could be a new creation in Jesus Christ today.
Amen.
Your soul is not worth homosexuality. It's not worth it. You need to hug your mother and father. Thank them that they didn't believe that lie from Satan. You need to thank them. They didn't believe that lie from Satan.